So that's why Jiraiya had sacrificed himself against pain. Oh, sorry. This is the last chapter. Let me start from the beginning. Let's go back to the first chapter. You may have seen many stories and theory of Naruto, but this one will be most unique from them. Without wasting time, let's start the story. So the story is about Master Jiraiya, one of legendary Sannin of Leaf Village. And question, is that why he sacrificed himself against pain? So the story starts from his childhood. Jiraiya was not born as prodigy or anything. We also don't know anything about his parents, family, or clan. Also at academy, he was not much intelligent. Even though he was assigned as member of Team 7 with Tsunade and Orochimaru, and his trainer was Lord Third Hokage. He eventually became one of the great names of Leaf Village. Now the main theories start from Chapter 2. As we know, after Hokage Hiruzen's death, Leaf Village elders summoned Jiraiya to tell him to take Hokage's position. But he refused about and suggested they should make Tsunade as Hokage. The main question arises from here, why he don't take Hokage's position. Is it because he was not interested in it, or there must be something else? So if we think about first option, it really don't convince us fully, because Jiraiya was a very intelligent shinobi, and saying no for Hokage at a time like this when the village is not in good position, it's not really convincing, so the first option can't be true. He had make that as an excuse to escape from the situation, so what's the real reason behind that? As we all know, Jiraiya roams into the whole shinobi world for traveling. At least that's what has been told into the manga. But I think that's not his true purpose, just think about it. At a time where villages are fighting with each other and many other problems are arising, why would a shinobi like Master Jiraiya, who was the strongest from village after Lord Third, would just roam around the world? And why would Lord Third would have given permission about that? I know you all are waiting to know the real reason, then here it is. So the most appropriate reason behind this is that, because no one knows Master Jiraiya from his looks, he roams around the villages and gather the information about them and pass it to village. Because of rivalry among villages, information would be the best weapon at a time like this. No, no, the theory won't end here. The most interesting part of this theory begins now. As I told in starting, that's why Jiraiya had sacrificed himself. So theory suggests that because Master Jiraiya roams around the villages, he had known about pain from very long time ago. Then question arises that why he didn't do anything. So it's because, although he had known about pain and some of his plans, he particularly don't know how to defeat him. But he knows that even if he had gone with all shinobi of Konoha, he can't defeat him before knowing his weakness. So first, as a backup, he taught Naruto the sage jutsu so that even if he can't defeat pain, Naruto will. And with this intention, after meeting Tsunade and convincing her to let him go alone, he goes there solo and even defeat one or two pains, but he can't defeat all of them. But he figured out the way to defeat them and send the message via Fukusaku to the village. Now coming to the final chapter, if you think Jiraiya was not powerful enough to defeat pain, that's also not true. Because if we think about his power, he was the sensei of two Hokage. Kakashi was powerful, but he can't fight one pain, whether Jiraiya almost killed two or them. And if you remember Itachi's world after he and Kisame run away from Jiraiya, that what makes him powerful enough to defeat pain, but the problem was that he was fighting all of them together without any information and also on their own place. That's why he lost but succeeded his mission. So at the end, conclusion draws that there was no other option for Master Jiraiya to find out truth about pain and defeat him. And he can't put others' life at risk, and that's why he took this step and sacrificed himself for the village. What an exceptional shinobi he was. This was the story and theory about Master Jiraiya, or Pervy Sage. Now if you like this and want to see more of them, hit that subscribe button and like the video.